It's sad that Louise was not half bad. It was written on the walls and window shades, and though she'd act a little girl, deceiver, don't believe her, that's a prey. Sometimes a bottle of perfume, flowers, and maybe some lace. Their intentions were easily traced, and everybody knew at times she cried. Oh, but women like Louise, they put it down below their kind. Still some cried when she died this afternoon. Louise rode home on the mail train, somewhere to the south, them say. Too bad it ended so ugly. Too bad she had to go this way. And the wind is blowing cold tonight. Okay, this is the lesson for a song called Louise by Paul Siebel and in the version of Leo Kottke. And you just heard me play it on a 12-string guitar, and it sounds, I think, at best on the 12-string guitar. But for ease of learning, and not everybody has a 12-string guitar, I will teach it on a 6-string guitar. And there is a version of Leo Kottke playing it on a 6-string guitar, so it's perfectly doable. And it's even easier, I think, on a 6-string than a 12-string. Well, for obvious reasons. The 12th string I played was tuned down to C, so an open E string sounds like a C, like this. And here we are in standard tuning, but well, in drop D tuning. So all the strings are in standard tuning, except the 6th string is tuned down to D. So you have D, D, E, B, G, D, A, and D. There's a solo, and that's played with a slide. And I can normally I play this, put the slide on the 3rd finger, but for this song I have to really put it on the pinky, because otherwise the fretting becomes too difficult. The song uses an alternating pattern, alternating bass, so between the 6th and the 4th string, and it does that throughout the song pretty much. Okay, let's get in tune. And let's start, you know, can find the link to the tablature in the video description. Always open the video description of my videos. There's always useful information there. So let's start with the first 4 bars. Started with a simple D chord, and the song used pretty much the same picking right hand pattern throughout. Move up with your index finger to get to that G chord. I mean, of course, this is a G chord with your 3rd finger on the 5th fret of the 6th string. Those first 2 bars are repeated, and then we have A chord, partial A chord, then move it up and leave your 3rd finger on the string and slide it to the next position like this. 3rd fret, 2nd string, and 4th fret, 4th string. That's why I take the chord, of course, with my 3rd and 2nd finger and not like this, because then the sliding up to the 4th fret becomes impossible. Let it ring into the next beat, and then 5th fret, 2nd and 4th string. This I play with my index and middle finger. That's thumb and middle finger. And also index and middle finger for that chord on the 5th fret. Okay, then we start with the vocal accompaniment. Without vocals, you see, there's not much happening. It's simply comping behind the vocals, and the same right hand pattern pretty much all the way through. And I play that. So this is with index, and those are with the middle finger. And sometimes that 2nd beat of the 6th measure, I play that open. So you have. And when we go to the E chord, we have to put our thumb on the second fret, sixth string, otherwise it's a D, and that's pretty off. Now it's a nice E7 chord. And this you have to play it with your third finger. And then open, again that chord. And we're walking into the G chord. Alright, I'll do it softly with vocals so it makes a bit more sense. They said that Louise was not a habit. It was written on the walls and window shades. The second ending in the 13th bar. Wait a couple, well, a beat. You can wait a little bit longer, that's not really important there. And then we're walking into the G chord again. So we're starting with that 14th bar, open chord, and then you see in the last beat of the 15th bar, it's not really a hammer, but by placing your fingers, second and third finger, that A chord, you get a little hammer on, but it's barely audible and it's not mandatory. To the D chord. And notice that in the 18th bar, that's with the temp, and then upstroke with index and middle finger. And you see, now in the introduction, I use these two fingers to grab that chord. Now I'm gonna play it with the first and the second finger because I'm going down like this. I'm doing that, then, well, then you can do that nice slide because you have to change position. So with this, it works. So we're back in the 19th bar. And now we're doing the same thing but higher up. And notice that in the second time through, I'm playing for, instead of the 21st bar, I'm playing the 17th bar again. It's just a slight difference, it's just that last note on the last beat. And then you only do once, while in the tab it's written. slight difference, a little variations. And in the performance video, I did it the first time, but like that, and the second time through, like that. Okay, 23rd bar. Most difficult chord now, that bar chord, that B chord. And that in that B chord, Leo doesn't do that well. He plays something like that, because on a 12 string it's really hard, and especially again with that slide on your pinky, it's hard to play bar chord. So you can fake it there if you have one of those heavy stringed 12 strings. Again to our E chord, and notice that the alternating bass pattern stays the same, but I'm removing my second finger to play it 2-2-2 open, like in the 27th and the 28th bar. And then again we have that. Okay, now let's do it softly with vocals.
Sometimes a bar of perfume flowers and maybe some lace man brought Louise tents and trinkets, their intention.
Note, I'm singing it slightly different than Leo Kottke, and that's of course a personal preference. I wrote the more or less the words under the tab where I sing them, but if you sometimes sing one word a bit longer or shorter, then well, the whole thing changes, and that's where your personal preferences come in. Okay. Then, so we had, and then we go back to bar 5, where we sing, and everybody knew at times she cried. Oh, but women like Louise, they get by. Now we go to the solo, that's on the second page of the tab. Notice that I'm trying to play rather clean the slide part, and I always mute. I drag my index finger over the strings after the slide, and then you're eliminating those buzzing sounds. You hear the difference? I think in this part, it's important that you try to play it as clean as possible. It's a beautiful song. It's an intimate song, and I don't think these rattling sounds belong there. Okay, so we're starting with the 31st bar. And it's, of course, not easy to put the slide on only one string, well, on the bottom four strings, but don't touch the fifth and the sixth string. So you have to be careful there. And it's the tip of the slide that covers the fourth string. So if you move it too high, you're gonna hit that fifth string, and too low, you're gonna miss it. So you have to pay attention there. And it takes a while to get it right. Now in the tab you will see under the tab, under certain notes, certain numbers, the F of fingered. There I'm gonna finger and not play it with a slide. So all the notes are, all the fretted notes with numbers higher than zero, are slide, used to play it with a slide, except those which have an F under written. So. Fingered. And then so that whole 35th bar and also the last beat of the 34th bar are fingered, and you have to use your thumb. That's the easiest part, your thumb to the fret, a sixth string, second fret, and those two other fingers. It's like an E minor chord, but with, it is an E minor chord. And Leo is a specialist in playing, well, I should say melody notes on the bass strings. And here you have that. That first beat, it's thumb, index, second beat, thumb, middle, third beat, thumb, index, and again middle of that 35th bar. One more time, the 34th and 35th bar. Then we slide to the 5th fret. Second ending is. And then we're going back to the beginning.
And everybody thought it kind of sad when they found.
Have a rest instead of I'm resting that for, let's say, dramatic effect. So we're going on with bar 15.
Louise rode home on the mail train. Somewhere I heard
pray. Too bad it ended so ugly. Too bad she had. Going to the beginning again, bar five. And the wind is blowing cold tonight. So good night, Louise. Good night. Solo one more time. Second ending of the solo, and then just the bass notes. And slide the second, third, and fourth string softly up to the seventh fret. And there's one thing you have to take care of when you play the solo the first time, which has two endings. Watch your speeds, because if normally when you play solo you're going to speed up because you don't have to have the words to keep you in check, and usually you speed up a little bit. But if you're too fast, then when you start again and everybody thought it kind of sad, if that is too fast, then you're ruining the song. So watch your speeds when you're playing the solo the first time through, and well, everything will be all right. Okay, it's a wonderful and beautiful song with a relatively easy accompaniment. And I hope you have fun with it.